Let's do an experiment. Close your eyes and I will give you some geographic information. This is Toulouse. More precisely, this is the area around the Institute of the Young Blind. You still don't know how to find it? Obviously, you did not get very much information, but this is exactly what a blind person would have perceived. Now, if you open your eyes, I will give you the same information again. This is Toulouse. More precisely, the area around the Institute of the Young Blind. As you have noticed, with the help of this visual map, you get very easily a lot of information about locations, about streets, about buildings, about parks, about rivers, and distances. Representations in form of a map are called allocentered representations. They are very helpful to get a spatial representation of an environment, but normally they are represented visually and thus not accessible for a blind person. This leads to the question, how can you present such information to a blind person? Historically, tactile maps are used for this purpose. These maps are pertinent for the creation of an ego-centered representation, but they possess some limitations. Most significantly, the number of information that can be transmitted by touch is inferior to the number of information that can be transmitted visually. Therefore, symbols and textures have to be used in order to represent geographic elements like parks, rivers, or public transportation. Often braille is used in order to indicate names. This is problematic as a big part of the visually impaired population cannot read braille and are thus excluded from the usage of those maps. A new and innovative solution are multimodal interactive maps. These maps promise to overcome the limitations of pure tactile maps. A multimodal interactive map consists of different components. First of all, there's a tactile map. We printed our map on swell paper and heated it in a fuser. This map is placed on a multi-touch device, which is connected to a computer with audio output. We use the Stanto multi-touch display. The multimodal map allows the user to obtain additional audio information on map elements. The user can explore the tactile map, following the outlines of streets and buildings and exploring textures and symbols. To obtain further audio information, the user can first press on a button on the map and then on the map element he's interested in. This produces an audio output indicating the element's name, like for example a street name. Information can be given for different elements, as streets, buildings, points of interest, or geographic elements. Audio output thus replaces braille information. Let's watch for a moment. For any further information on the project, please contact us at IRID Research Lab in Toulouse, France.